A big thank you to GoDaddy for sponsoring this video. GoDaddy Managed WordPress Hosting is a great way to quickly create and host your WordPress site. Go to bit.ly/JamieWP to get 30% off your Managed WordPress Hosting today. Good morning. Today you're going to learn how to create a sticky navigation for your website, just like this on apple.com, using any WordPress block theme with no plugins and no code. Here we go. So here I am in the site editor. Now this will work on any block theme. This is actually the 2024 default theme, but I've tested this on a whole bunch of other themes. It works in exactly the same way. I've done nothing to this site apart from customize the design slightly. This is actually for a tutorial that I'm putting together where I replicate the apple.com website coming next week. Subscribe if you want to see that recreation. But here I have my header along the top. I've just customized it using the site editor. And you'll see here's my header component over on the right. And all you need to do is this. So you click on these three dots here, come down here, and you're going to group it. You click group, and that adds that group to your header. Now you can rename these as well at this point if you want to make it a bit more intuitive for you. So I might just call this sticky header. And then there's two other things we need to do. Now when you group something in the site editor, it's going to constrain the proportions to the theme width. So you're going to come across here and just deselect this where it says inner blocks use content width. Otherwise it's going to be too short, too narrow rather. And then the other thing we want to do is come down here and we're going to choose position sticky. And that means this group element now will stick to the top. And you'll see as I scroll up, that's now stuck to the top. We have to group it first because for something to be sticky, it has to be within some other element. And that's why we're grouping it. And there we go. That's what you do. We've got it a nice sticky navigation along the top there. Super simple. And that applies to all the templates because we've actually added it to the header template part, which is used in all our templates. So all our pages, all our posts, everything on the site. But that's not all. There's a few other cool things you can do as well. One of those is you can make the navigation bar along the top here slightly transparent. You'll see as I scroll up here, see how the images are slightly shown behind it. It's a really cool, subtle effect. All we need to do is add some transparency to that group block. I'm back in the site editor. I'm going to select this group block here, which is the actual one that's applying these background styles here. Come across to your styles, which is that little icon over on the right. Select background, and then you click on this color here. This is your current background. Then you have these two color pickers. This is the main color. This is actually the transparency slider here, and you'll see as I move it up, the transparency will increase of my header background. So I chose a fairly opaque one because I like a nice little effect. And of course, you can use exactly the same sticky position functionality if you want to add a sales banner to the top of your website on specific pages. Here we go. I've got a winter sale now on up here, and you see as I scroll, because it's got position sticky, it stays right at the top of the site. And here's a look behind the scenes how I actually did that. Very straightforward. All I did was added the row block, which is actually a type of group block. I made it sticky in the normal way by coming over here to position and choosing sticky. Then within the row block, I just added a heading block here. And then next to that, I added the buttons block, all core Gutenberg blocks, all no code. Here's another cool trick. This time we have our sales bar fixed to the bottom of the website. So as the user scrolls up, the sales bar remains there. Again, this is using blocks. We can't use sticky position for this because that will stick it to the top. We're going to do this with a tiny, tiny bit of custom CSS. There are just three simple steps to get this working on your own sites. It's really simple. First, create your design. I've done this by adding a row block, which is a type of group block. I've added a background color, and I've added within there two blocks, a heading block and a buttons block. Very, very simple. Step two, you want to give that a custom class. So you come across to advanced here, make sure you have the row block selected, and you add your custom class. Now you can use exactly the same classes as me. I will put a link to these in the description below so you can just copy the CSS code, but it's incredibly simple. I've just called mine bottom menu here. Then once you've added that class, you need to add the custom CSS. This is super easy. You just come to the style editor here and come across to your custom CSS, which you can find just here. And this is the custom CSS that I added. That basically just says to that row block, I want to fix it to the bottom of the website. Again, I will link to this code so you can just copy and paste it on your own site. Then just make sure you save it. And now you have a sticky footer. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that and found it really useful. If you did, please, 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 if you could hit that like button now, it would be amazing because it makes a huge, huge, huge difference in terms of how many people actually get to see this video. It really does. So if you can hit that like button, thank you very much. And also, every time you do hit that like button, our cats get a little treat. Thank you. I've got tons more amazing content planned for 2024. So if you want to see that, hit that subscribe button and you'll be notified every time I release a new video. Keep well, and I'll see you soon. Bye for now.